Mr. Conley, are you ready for your question?
I think I am.
We'll begin with Debra Plowman and then we'll come right back to the seat.
It's great to hear in your opening statements what you believe about core principles to us, especially in the faith community and as conservatives. But I'd like to know not only what your position is in regard to upholding the Defense of Marriage Act, as our present Attorney General is not doing, but I'd like to know what you would do specifically in regard to this or any other law that was not being executed by our government and by our Attorney General, specifically in regard to DOA and specifically in regard to any other law that deals with same-sex marriage or the attempted redefinition of marriage.
It is the duty of the legislature or the Congress to pass the laws. It's the duty of the president to appoint persons who will uphold the laws. It's the duty of the courts to interpret the laws. In today's Washington, the legislature, the Congress makes the laws, the president ignores the laws, and the Supreme Court makes and legislates from the bench. None of this is appropriate. The fault lies with the president. The president has chosen people who will not enforce the laws as passed by Congress. If you think that that is what our founders meant, I would say otherwise. Our founders meant for everyone to do their part of the triangle that we have, the triangle of power, the three-legged stool. Congress can make better laws. We can have a better president. And we need a Supreme Court that understands what its role is as well. I think that the person who needs to be held accountable is the President of the United States.
First thing I would do, if I'm your senator, is to try to get a constitutional amendment, a marriage between one man and one woman, get three-quarters of the states to ratify it, and that way it would take care of that problem. Again, why am I running? Why have I been in this race for 2 years? When Senator Snow had an opportunity to vote one man and one woman as a constitutional amendment, she voted undecided. These are the reasons I'm getting into this race. This is the reason I've been fighting for. Well, I also want you to know, the senator that you send to D.C. will be the one that sits face to face with the next Supreme Court justice. And in the next 4 years, that decision is going to be one of the most important decisions facing this country. If we get a Supreme Court justice along the lines of Sonia Sotomayor and Elena Kagan and Ruth Gantzheimer, we're done. It isn't going to matter what we the people want. They're going to push through their agendas like they already are now. They're legislating from the bench. And our senator, both our senators, supported Elena Kagan and Sonia Sotomayor. And Snow also supported Ruth Gantzheimer. So I can't stress how important that is as your senator to follow the Constitution and stop legislating from the bench and getting these judges to follow the Constitution. Thank you.
Well, there's several elements to your question, so let me try to address a couple of them. One is that I firmly believe that the definition of marriage should be between one man and one woman. I think I also have respect for the law, and I particularly respect the law that is passed by the people of Maine. And there have been several votes on this issue here in Maine, and the people of Maine have decided that marriage should be defined, as I suggested, between one man, one woman. And we need to to uphold that, respect it. In my view, as a as an elected public official, I'm always troubled by the efforts from the legislature, from the executive branch, from the court, in undoing the express will of the people. I think it's fundamental to our democracy and fundamental to respect of who's really in charge of our democracy, to respect the will of the people. And particularly when it's expressed in public referendum, it's no clearer. But there's always efforts to erode and change the law because, you know, the administration doesn't like it, so he appoints people that are going to interpret a certain way, or make some executive order or a signing statement, which thwarts the will of the law, the appropriate lawmaking authority, whether it's the people or the legislature, the Congress, and I think it needs to stop. And it really, fundamental to me in my public record is respect for the will of the people.
I am a pro-life, traditional marriage Catholic. That's what I believe. I also believe in the Constitution. And I also realize that the root of many of our problems is that our federal government is too big, it's too expensive, and it's too intrusive. The states have always determined the definition of marriage. We have done that several times, as was just mentioned here, in the state of Maine. And we have an opportunity again to do it this November. If I have the opportunity to serve as the next United States Senator, I will believe what I believe in, which I just told you, but I will also uphold the Constitution. I do not believe the federal government should be involved in defining marriage. That should be something reserved for the states, which in my mind is very clear in the 10th Amendment.